Hey gang, it is August 24th, 2017, and you are watching Sneaker Files Live. Hey guys, welcome to Sneaker Files Live, hosted by Brookie Du. I'm Eugene, the sidekick of this thing, and I guess we'll get right into it. You can find us online at sneakerfiles.com. You can find us on Twitter at sneakerfiles, and you can also find us on Instagram at sneakerfiles_podcast. And here's your host, Brooke.
Hey guys, what's going on today? Sorry for the little bit of a wait. Wasn't sharp at 8:30 for some technical problems, but we're here and we're ready to get into it this week.
So you want to get into how you want to start the day, what's happened the last week or so?
Yeah, for sure. So my AirPods aren't working, so I'm going to try to talk very loud for you guys. I don't know. I just got a new computer, so I'm trying to get everything connected, and I should have had it done before, so I'm sorry. So hopefully you all can hear me. So I hope everyone had a really great week. This week was seriously a lot of stuff dropped. So let's get into pretty much what has happened to me the past week since you guys last saw the recording, where we pre-recorded because I was in New York. And I actually was able to meet up with a homie, a part of the Sneaker Files podcast, Hypeless Joe, if you know him. So it was really cool to be able to see him. We ended up meeting at Kip. We all got milkshakes together, so it was a very nice little connection that me, his girl, and my girl all had. So that was pretty cool. The Captain Crunch milkshake is phenomenal, so if you're ever at Kip, you need to try it. Have you ever been to Kip, Eugene, and had a milkshake?
No, never. I've never been to New York as, like, you know, a grown person, and I can't have milk. I can't have dairy, so I wouldn't have had a milkshake anyways.
Yeah, I'm not really supposed to have it either, but cereal is involved. But the next day, I really paid for it, but we won't get in. So I really haven't been too crazy on my pickups recently, just because I do want to kind of save for a lot of heat that's coming out. So recently, today, I was able to get a pickup from the Supreme online store, and that was really hard. Like, I really super duper worked for that. I was hoping when we went to New York that I could have just went into the store and got it, but when we went, I'm being dead serious, the lines were just wrapped around. Like, there were four or five different lines that you had to wait in to get into the store. And from what I heard when we were at Kip, me and Joe were talking to someone, or he was telling me that someone actually waited all day, like, to get in that line to go in, and the store was closing, so they told him that they couldn't go. So that really sucks. But this morning I copped a t-shirt off of the Supreme website. It was actually, I really didn't think I was gonna get it. What happened was, I had it in my cart, I went to check out, I kept getting an error message. I had my iMac open, my phone open, my iPad, just kept getting an error message. A half hour later goes by, I'm still trying, and then I just got to the point where I was like, I'm done with this shit, this is pissing me off, I'm gonna go to the gym. And I get an email saying that your order has been confirmed, it will be shipped in 2 to 3 days, blah, 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 this and that. And I still had all these windows open on, like, my devices, so I closed them out, like, super quick, because I just had a shit ton of stuff. And I was like, oh shit, I hope I don't, like, get the same stuff, like, over and over again. But I only secured one item from that due to the website crashing. And yes, that's about it. I may have locked down a pair of the Flyknit trainers in the pink, but we'll continue that at the end of the show.
I guess I haven't really picked anything up lately, so it's going to be kind of quiet for me. Yesterday we recorded the episode of the podcast. It was like a little some critical error that happened, so I don't know exactly how that's going to come out, but stay tuned. You'll know what I mean.
Okay, cool. I'll be able to find that out then. But yeah, I'm kind of just like saving because we're going to really talk about a lot of stuff that's coming out. Kind of wanted to let you guys know, in New York, I do go quite often. A couple of my favorite spots to go are Kith. I really like that store. The first time, I actually went to Nike Town this time around, and it was so crazy. The Nike store had 5 stories to it. It was super dope, too, because Leah was looking for a pair of running shoes, and she actually got to try them on. She also got to run on a treadmill and test them. And a really big reason why I like going to a Nike store rather than like a Foot Locker or something like that is because I feel like very welcome when I'm in stores like that, and also like Adidas, because they're very personable. I don't know if they're commissioned or not, but they don't really push you to buy anything, which is like super duper nice. Like they just want to like have a conversation with you and like talk about like working out, running, yoga, whatever, and sneakers. So like to me, I feel a lot better when I'm in a store like that. I've had experiences where when I go to Foot Locker, I feel like I'm buying a car. Like, it's just like, they're like, oh, you want these? You want them? It's just like, yo, put your brakes on. But yeah, that's about it. I love Kith, though. Kith is such a cool atmosphere. I also like this place called Sage. I'm really into, like, oils and different ways to smell, like, really nice. And also, like, for your body. So that's a pretty cool place. Check it out. But yeah. So let's get into the next segment. What do you say?
All right, let's do it.
So for the fit of the week, I've actually been really, really rocking my 97 Silver Bullets, like, hard. And it's actually funny that you sent me a picture of yours yesterday, didn't you?
It was yesterday. It was the first time I've ever even taken them out of the box since the day I bought them. So it was time for me to finally crack them in.
How do you own quite a few 97s, right?
No, I haven't. I haven't owned them since the last time they retro, which was ages ago, and I didn't even get the OG retro colorways. And the ones I wore yesterday, they fit really, really snug, like from what I remember.
They're super duper tight. I actually got my first 97s, and I had to send them back because I got my true size 8 women's, and I was just like, I put them on my feet, and I was like, damn. Like, oh my god, like I need a half size, or even I could even do a full size up. But yeah, so if anyone's out there thinking about getting a pair of 97s, definitely go up half a size or a full size, because they definitely aren't snug. But comfort wise, I think they're super duper comfortable.
No, they're really stiff. I think yesterday we were talking about it, my feet started hurting just because of how stiff it is. Like, there's no bend to the thing at all. And at the same time, like, it was just squishing my toes. And the shitty part is I got a size 11 of the silvers, and before I even tried them on, I ended up buying the gold as well in the same size. So I have 2 pairs. That's too small for me.
You can always sell them. They definitely do go for a little more over retail, so you might be able to, you know, get your monies back and a little bit more. But I've really been digging I've been wearing the 97s. It has, like, another reason why I've been wearing them is because I think, like, shoes like that look kind of cool with, like, some wear to them and beat up. And we've had, like, really shitty weather this past week. So I wore those. And I also wore my trainers. And the trainers are super duper comfortable. So I really, really am happy with that shoe. I really like the trainers, just the feel of it. I would compare the narrow, it's kind of like a racer, but if you get more comfort from it, it's not as, like, you can rock them with wide feet. Like, a lot of people that have wide feet can't wear racers because it just doesn't work for them. And I always just wear joggers. Like, you can pull off joggers with any of those shoes. So I usually just wear joggers. So let's get into the next segment then. And that's going to be That's My Drawing. So this week we had the Supreme. I was successful, like I said, with one item, the Find It Trainer in pink. Still, I will let you know at the end of this show, perhaps, if that is the answer or no. But reason, like, kind of like how you just said, he's kind of been slow down with, you know, his purchases. Another really big reason on why I kind of am slow too is there's a couple of shoes that are coming out that I do really want. And there's also shoes that previously came out that I really want to add to my collection, but I really just need to find the right price and just the right time in general for them, because all of these sneakers are up there in cost for resale. So I'll get into it. So this is my Heat wish list. This is kind of something new that I want to bring. A lot of times we all, you know, look at sneakers, we'll hunt for stuff. And that's a really big reason why I like being a sneakerhead, is because I like to, I love the hunt and the challenge to kind of find a shoe. So as you see, the one of the first ones is going to be the Mars. And I love that shoe. You don't have them, do you?
No, I do not. I think, I don't know anyone that has them. I think the only person that I've seen have them was Kicksteel CA.
Yeah. How much did he pay for his pair?
I didn't ask him, but he said he had to sell a pair of Yeezys or something like that just to get them. No, but honestly, are you actually going to wear your Yeezys that often, or do you want something that's like ultra rare, like those Mars Yards?
Oh, hell yeah. I would definitely trade a Yeezy for the Mars Yards, and even trade for sure. The problem is just like going through the hassle of like I was telling you earlier today, like people just like lowball and like try to sell shit. It's so annoying. Like I have a pair of NMDs that I'm selling online right now, and people are just like, it's like, get out of here. Like, this is not a yard sale. But no, I would definitely trade a pair of Yeezys for them. I don't know what Yeezy I would trade, though.
Whichever one's worth the most.
Maybe, yeah, that's true. I wouldn't want to trade my Zebras because I do really like them and I wanted those for a while. Wouldn't trade my Moonrocks. I would probably trade the Pink Stripe one.
Yeah, you could do that. It depends on which one you want more. You want the Yeezys or you want those Nikes, right? And for me, I think Yeezys are a lot easier to replace than the Nike Mars Yards.
Oh my God, yeah, you could definitely replace them. But yeah, so that's definitely something that I'm really looking into right now. I've kind of done some research. The price is kind of dropping a little bit on them from what I'm seeing. But that's the thing, is when it drops, that's when the best time is to buy it, because then it just starts to become more rare and one-able, so the price is going to go up even more. Another shoe, and I kind of want to hear your opinion, so if you are watching this, I would love some participation in the chat. This next shoe is the Supreme Jordan 5 Desert Camel. I really love this shoe. It is so expensive in my size. It's about the cheapest I can find it. It's probably, I think it's like is 800, 900, 1,000, and that's just way too much for me. The most I would pay for this shoe is $400 to $500, that's going to be super duper hard to get. Another shoe, two of them that are kind of a little bit similar, are going to be the Air Jordan 1, the shattered backboard, and also the shattered backboard. So Eugene, I asked you, I'm a boss. Which one I should go for? You didn't say the reverse. You don't like the reverse?
It's not that I don't like them, but if you're going to get a pair of shattered backboards, you have to start with the first release before you get the reverse, right? That's just my opinion.
No, I feel you on that. It's hard to find my size, though, in it. It's tough. That's another guy that's about in the $400 to $500 range. I've always wanted that shoe. I really like it a lot. I actually had a chance to buy it for a really cheap price, and I turned it down, and I'm feeling like an idiot now. Next one, we talked about it before, is the Supreme Uptempo. I really want an Uptempo in general. I actually tried my first pair on when I was on my break at work at Foot Locker, and I really like the way that the shoe looks on me. I wasn't sure if I would or not. I tried on the tri-color ones, and they're actually pretty a dope shoe.
Which ones?
The tri-color ones that have like the hints of like white, gray, and black. They kind of like go in that three-color route. They actually look really nice. And then, of course, we've all talked about the Vapor Clots. I do really like that shoe. I have found pretty good pricing on that, around the $300 range. So that might be something, but it's definitely not top of this list. So, yeah. So this is my Heat wish list of things that have already came out and things that I'm on the hunt to find at a good price. Any of these guys on your wish list?
A lot of them are. It's just that I don't know exactly what priority I want to get these things. It's just that
I'm looking at your wish list. It's like, you got the Shattered Backboards and the Reverse Shattered Backboards. You got the Supreme Fives, the Clot, and the Supreme Up Tempos. Like, for me, the Supreme Up Tempo is not my favorite, but I used to have a pair of the original Shattered Backboards, but I wasn't really feeling the colorway on those, so I ended up selling them for a pretty good price. But the one I'm actually really seeking out is probably the Clot.
The resale is not too terrible on that, though, from what I'm seeing.
It really depends on what size you are and how you're going about getting it.
Yeah, I can agree to that. So, something, though, that is on my radar that does come out tomorrow before we get into the news, the feed, is I really, really am intrigued, and I love the concept behind it, and I really like the shoe. It's going to be the Kenny Moore, the Cortez pack that is dropping tomorrow. I either want to go for the white pair or the yellow and the blue. I really, really, really like this whole entire just feel of the shoe. I think it's super duper cool. I think it has a lot of really just really special highlights to it. Like in the inside of the Kenny Moore shoe, it's kind of, it goes into like in depths of, I think it was when he broke one of his bones or something like that. So I really, really like this collection. And it's actually crazy because Kenny Moore was one of the first product testers and contributors for Nike. So I really think that that's really dope that there is a collection based on him. What do you think of these, Eugene?
Well, the Cortez is actually one of those shoes that I think is way underrated. And I absolutely don't mind this concept. It's just I don't know too much about Kenny Moore. So at the same time, if I were to get a pair of Cortez, I wouldn't mind any of these, really.
Yeah, I'm torn between the white and the yellow ones. I like how it says Moore, though, in the white one, like kind of written like that. I think that's going to be a pair that looks super duper nice beat up and like a really great shoe for the fall. I think that's a really good one there. All right, cool. So, and two guys, if you're watching and if you like any of the things that I put on the heat list, or there's something that you agree with or disagree, or you think it's whack and shouldn't be on my list, let me know. I'm always open to positive and negative feedback, so let us know. So let's get into the news. So like we said before, there's a lot of stuff that's coming out this week, this weekend especially too, and then in September, early September, there's a lot of stuff that's dropping. So let's get into it. Don't want to waste too much of your time tonight since we kind of kept you waiting a little bit. So we have the Jordan 5 Desert Camo. So back to my heat wish list. I really like this shoe, but in the back of my mind, I'm like, why settle for this when you know you want the Supreme? But then at the same time, I've watched a couple on foot videos on YouTube of this. And I actually, there's a guy on Instagram, I think it's Buck City Soul. He did a photograph in these and they looked phenomenal. So these might be something that I pick up. I'm not too sure yet if I'm gonna pull the trigger on them.
What? Wait. Do you feel like these are like a consolation prize for you for not getting the Supreme Fives?
See, that's how I feel. I feel like it's kind of like, I feel like this is like the generic version. Like, I feel like it's when you go to like a grocery store and you buy their brand of soda. When you're not buying, like, do you know what I mean? Like, I feel like,
yeah,
it's
the house brand of the Supreme Fives, right? So I remember you messaged me asking me about how I felt about them, and then you also told me that you wanted the Supreme Fives, and straight up I just told you, I'm like, maybe you should save your money, not get the GR camos, and just hunt down a pair of Supremes, and that way you can, you know, just, you don't need both, you need one.
I know, and the Supremes are way better. You know what? Fuck it. I'm going to hunt the Supremes. I'm going to be on it. I'm going to be up like a fiend tonight. But no, I really want to find them. So I'm definitely going to have to do that because I need them. But besides that, I really do like this, but I really do like the Supreme ones. It's really tough because I feel like it's the generic way to go, and a lot of people know me. I can be bougie, so I don't know if I want to get them, but yes, I should probably hunt the Supremes. But the next topic is VaporMax is back, with two colorways. So the triple whites, they're super clean, but here's my thoughts. I have the pure platinums. They look way too similar in my opinion. But I will say I do like the bottom of the bubbles of the triple whites, like that bottom part, more than I do of the platinums. But it's too similar. And especially with the price tag of the VaporMax, and I do really love that shoe, but it's too similar. So I would have to pass on the triple whites. What are you feeling?
I don't know. I don't have the platinum, so these triple whites might be a good option for me. And I'm starting to slowly buy a few more VaporMaxes here and there. It's just like the retail price tag of them is just a little bit too high for me. But there's more VaporMaxes on the way, and maybe this one can wait.
Yeah. I really like, and we'll talk about which one. I'll say that later when we get into the next article here. But there's another one, and I think this one's kind of dope. This is kind of like a hint of blue and a cool gray. I haven't heard any release on this. At first, I thought it was like the JD Sports one, but I kind of like this one a little bit more. I feel like there's more gray in the top of the toe box, and then it kind of like has that. I really like the bottom part, how it's dark. But that's another one that I may have to wait on. But the triple whites are definitely really cool. So that triple white VaporMax, if you don't have the pure platinums, I would say that this is going to be a really nice, like, snowball shoe. So I would recommend getting that. But for me, I already have the platinums. Have you heard anything, Eugene, of this next topic I'm going to go into? The rumors of a Kith collaboration with LeBron James, your favorite player?
LeBron James, definitely not my absolute favorite player, but I saw that Kith is starting to collab with a couple of NBA stars, and I heard nothing about it. I just haven't had time to read everything on the social media at the moment.
Yeah, I know. I hear you on that. Life's been pretty busy, but I think this is super cool. I think this could be something a little bit different outside of like Kith's element, because they usually do collabs with like NMDs or Saucony and Asics. So I think this could be really cool. I also heard that there could even be up-tempo collaboration with them as well.
I don't know if it's up-tempo, but they did say that Kith is working with Scottie Pippen, and of course one of his most iconic silhouettes was the Air More up-tempo, but Scottie Pippen actually had a couple of signature shoes with Nike as well, so it could be anything really. And knowing Kith and how Ronnie Feig works, he might choose a less well known silhouette just to give it that kind of spotlight. And I think Ronnie Feig actually does that really well, getting younger generation to learn about a silhouette that they may have missed when it was hot back in the day.
Yeah, I think that would be pretty dope. So I'm looking forward to that, seeing what's happening. There's a lot of collaborations coming out. We're going to talk a little bit about them next. So this kind of, like, I threw this one in here. This kind of made me laugh. So I don't know if any of you guys know, Nike came out with a shoe called 4%. I actually was able to check it out in New York when I went. So this shoe is really made for, like, dedicated runners. So if you're a marathon runner, half marathon runner, or you just run a lot, this shoe is actually just made for you to run your racing. So the quality of the shoe is crazy on comfort, but the life of the shoe is only made for, I think it's like 200 miles. So the 4% is a shoe that you don't train in. It is only a shoe that you run in like on your like day of race. The 2% are what you train in and run in. These are crazy. This is really cool, but it really kind of makes me mad the fact that they did a color for Kevin Hart, because when does he ever run? Like, what? Like, that's, it just makes me laugh. But I'm into this purple one. I actually really want to get this shoe, but the price tag on it is crazy high. It's $250. Do you know anyone who owns it?
I know that the 4% are actually starting to get quite a bit of traction in the athletic world, and a lot of people are recommending this shoe, but they don't understand that you have to get the Zoomfly, the 2% and the 4% as like a companion pack, and that's really how you should be doing it. And I don't think, like, up here is 250 No, $300 something, $315 Canadian. And that's an expensive shoe to like do your groceries wearing. And it's not a shoe that you walk around with, but people are saying that they're so comfortable that you should get a pair just to walk around in. And I think that's the wrong application for this silhouette.
No, I totally agree with you, but I will say they are really comfortable. Even the 2% are super duper comfortable. So if you want to like whip your groceries, get the 2% at least, then don't get the shoe. Like really, like get the shoe if you're a runner. Like, I don't understand it. But I think it's crazy the fact that it's like Kevin Hart has his own colorway when he's not even a runner. But I definitely want to get this shoe because personally I am a runner. And I have a couple races that I'm going to be doing in the next year. So I think that that will be really cool. My thing, though, is I'm kind of, like, on the fence about a kind of a shoe like that because I like to have, like, my shoe to be a little bit worn so I'm used to it. Like, me knowing I'm going into, like, a 15-mile run in a shoe that I've never worn, like, really, like, ran long before in kind of, like, scares me a little bit. I don't know. But next topic. So this came out today in the U.S. on the sneakers app. It is the trainers. We only were able on the Nike sneakers app to get the original returns. I personally already have mine, and I love them. But it's actually crazy because I was kind of like contemplating on doubling up on these, and I went to click on the sneakers app at like 10:01 after I decided maybe I should, and they were already sold out. So then I got mine because I would have hated to take another L if I didn't get them then. Did you double up today or no?
No, they actually only released in store in most of Canada. We already got our first nationwide release on Nike.ca, the Canadian Nike e-commerce website. So I wasn't able to get a pair through there, but I was able to get a little help and buy a pair pretty much at retail, minus, you know, a couple dollars for gas for the dude that was helping me out. So I got a pair, and I would have doubled up, except it was all in-store release only, and it's one of those deals where they would go online if there are remaining pairs. And of course, it's such a popular shoe, even on a weekday it's sold out, and that doesn't surprise me at all. But what I do like about this release is that anyone that basically wanted a pair, if they actually put in work, they were able to get a pair because they had two chances up here. And the resale is basically at par. There's not much profit to be made. So if you absolutely need a pair in your collection, you can get one pretty much at retail. So I don't mind that strategy from Nike at all this year.
Yeah, it's actually crazy. So I went on StockX, and I was just curious to see because it actually makes me laugh how so many people buy shoes before the reseller even gets them in hand. So, like, you'll see, like, scrolling through on eBay, just, like, confirmations, like, even with Supreme today, which kind of, like, makes me laugh. Like, what if someone stole your mail? Or, like, you don't know what's going to happen. Like, I don't know. That kind of makes me laugh. But besides that, we only had the OG ones today. However, on sneakers and stuff, I believe Titolo and a couple other like European sites, they released both the cream, the dark ones, and I actually really like the gray ones because I'm not really a big white shoe person. I was actually super shocked that I like the pure platinums as much as I do because I don't like light shoes. I dress very dark, and I kind of like more of darker colors. So for me, I really like this pair. I'll be honest, I may have picked that pair over the OG ones. Sharp gray ones.
I actually, up until like very, very recently, I was checking online and they were still available. They did like a surprise drop up here on Nike.ca, and both the sunset or the peach or salmon or whatever you want to call it, and the pale grays, they were both available online and like in sizes too. And like I had them sitting in my cart for a while, and I was just waiting to pull the trigger, and I was like desperately searching for like either coupon codes or some sort of rebate or anything just so I can like take the hit a little bit softer, because I just got the white blacks, right? So it's still gonna be maybe wait for any kind of discount for me.
Do you think they'll still be in stock, though?
It's a very odd pattern up here. Like, if they don't sell it on day one, they're gonna sit for a while. Maybe it's gonna sit for another week. I don't really know. Maybe people just didn't realize that they actually had come out online. I really have no clue why they sat around. Like, do you think in the States, if they came out online today, they would sell out?
Yeah. U.S. like sneakers app sells out like super duper quick. Like, I forget who I was listening to. I think I was listening to the Sneak This. Really great group of guys. I was actually on their show before. They record Wednesday nights. I was listening to their podcast this morning, and they were kind of talking about like how they, like, a lot of people like in the U.S., like in certain states, really like the sneakers app sells out like super easy. So, for example, those like eggplant Foamposites, they sold out like super quick. And to me, I've never owned a Foamposite. I think the idea of it's kind of cool, how the shoe's kind of like a concept of space. But at the same time, they sold out like super quick, but they're still sitting at like other retailers like Foot Locker or Finish Line. But a lot of stuff sells out really fast on Nike, and I really believe the reasoning behind that is because Nike is one of the brands or websites or whatever you buy from them, you can return it, you can wear it, and it's free returns. So if you buy a shoe from like a Finish Line or a Foot Locker or a Champs and you wear it, they're not taking that shit back. Nike, you legit can even do it. Like, me and Leo were talking to a guy at the Nike store in New York. He's like, we've had people buy those 4%, we'll beat the shit out of them for 28 days, and then return them. I really believe a big reason why Nike's doing so great right now is because, like, they're kind of like how there's a lot of rumors with, like, Foot Locker going out of business, whatever, is because their return policy and their customer service is just way better.
I think that Nike's always had that kind of policy where you can return stuff because they actually want you to try their product before you actually commit to getting it. And I think that's great. And it does really put a lot of the smaller, not even smaller, like we're talking about like Footaction. They're pretty up there, and like they can't really compete with that kind of policy.
Yeah, I think that's totally great on their end. Before we get into another shoe, lineup of shoes, a big reason why I kind of am drawn to the pink one is because I don't have any pink shoes. So that is kind of something that draws me to it a little bit, but at the same time, it's why, I don't know, I'm kind of weird like that. Like, I don't like to get things that, like, I don't really normally wear a lot, but at the same time, it's like, this could be a nice, like, little outfit top. But who knows? We'll see. I'll keep you guys posted if I do or not. But besides that, there are two colors that are rumored. Like we said before, these pictures right here, they're rumors, not saying it's true. I have no idea, but I really hope it is. How do you feel about these purple and greens, Eugene?
It's nice, but it's a solid color, right? It looks like it's almost a solid color all the way through. And I don't know if the pictures aren't showing it properly, but the main attraction to me and most of the Flyknit racers and trainers is the multiple gradient coloring effect and how it's an isometric design on both the instep and outsole, or the medial and lateral side of the shoe. And that's the most interesting part about the trainers and the racers. But if you have a shoe that's a solid color all the way through, that takes away a lot of the design elements that was like painstakingly put in before to have multiple color knit pattern.
Yeah, I agree with you. At first, I was into the purple ones, but now that I'm like really looking at them more, I would pass on the purple ones. The green ones are a cop for sure, but I would pass on the purple ones.
Yeah.
Crazy because that olive VaporMax is, I don't know how that's still sitting some places. I really don't. I think like if I didn't have already three or four pairs of VaporMaxes, I would buy that shoe. I love dark green.
Yeah, I can see that should be selling out, but I think it's been maybe a few years now that Adidas has started coming out with like the Trace Olive and the Olive colorway for their running shoes. I think people might be burnt out of that colorway, and even like your pattern of the camouflage, those don't do so hot anymore in store. So people maybe are staying away from the fatigue look, and maybe it's just, it's the year of the white and bright shoes, maybe.
Yeah, I dig it, but I still like my dark ones. But besides that, let's get into the next segment here. So it was revealed that Off-White is dropping 10 sneakers. What are your thoughts on this, Eugene?
It is what it is. We actually had, like, on the recording last night, we had like a 45-minute very passionate discussion about this series. And Joe actually brought up a very, very good point.
What's that?
That is, why is Off-White or Virgil getting 10 shoes? Why is Nike throwing 10 shoes at him when they couldn't do the right thing and keep Kanye around to the Nike swoosh brand? And out of like a this is the first collab that this brand's gonna have with Nike, and they get 10 signature shoes, and out of that 10, you put a Chicago 1 in there, maybe do a few things here and there, and then work your way up to something as iconic as a Jordan 1. Like, according to Joe, that shoe's untouchable. You can't really, you know, mess with that shoe, and especially for like a first-time designer, not a first-time designer, first-time collaborator, like the first shot is the Chicago 1s. And I love the concept of this, because it's going to, it's basically, to me, this feels like it's someone's customs that's made mass produced and for sale. Instead of being like a theme shoe, it looks like someone's actual customs being sold. And there's a few silhouettes I really like. Do you feel any of these, or is it just one or two?
Yes. So I kind of want to talk a little bit about just the whole thing before I get into what I like. I love this. I think this is awesome, and I think it's so incredible how this collaboration, like, he legit, like, redesigned the shoe. And I know Joe says it's untouchable, and I totally agree. Like, the Jordan 1 is my favorite Jordan out of all of the Jordans. You see my collection, you know my heat list, my want list. But I really think it's great how he, like, redesigned certain things of the shoe. And what really I love the most is you get a fucking marker, like, in your box to really, like, create your own. And I think this is crazy. Like, Nike blew Adidas, like, out of the water with this. Like, this is insane. Like, this is untouchable. This honestly is probably, to me, that Off-White Air Jordan 1 is the best shoe I've seen all year.
You think the Jordan 1 Off-White is the best shoe you've seen all year? And see, that's an...
I've been looking at this shoe since they released the rumors of it months ago. I am in love with this shoe. Like, in love. And it sucks. Because I know I'm going to have to fucking pay resale for it. Because I need to have it in my collection. Like, I need it.
Do you have any clue what the resale price of the Chicago 1's going to be?
Yeah, you're going to buy me a pair, right?
I think you have a better shot than me with your size and everything. But the entire capsule collection, or whatever you want to call it, of the 10 shoes, the most interesting to me is the Converse. Because that's under the Nike umbrella, and that is so spontaneous and unpredictable that they would throw a Converse in there. I'm like, okay, I didn't see that coming. Now that's exciting to me. But Jordan 1s, I like my Jordan 1s the way I remembered Mike playing in them. So it's not that, you know, you can't do that. That's like, you can't.
I know, Jordan, but this shoe, it's more of the just the design. Like, don't look at it as the story behind the Air Jordan 1. Look at it more of like a creative, like, just canvas. That's like kind of how I'm looking at it. Like, but I'll be honest with you. So when these come out online, I'm not even going to try to get the Jordan 1 because I'm going to take an L. I'm going to try to get either the Air Max or the Vapor Max or a Presto, whatever. Because what I'm thinking is that when these do drop online, the most heated shoe is going to be that shoe, and it's going to be impossible to get. Impossible.
That's the thing. It is impossible, and like, you kind of learned your little mini lesson when the Jordan 1 restock happened. And you were going for the high profile shit when like the other stuff was kind of sitting for a minute, and you kind of slept on them.
Yeah, because I wanted, I want the All Stars as well. I really love that. I fucking love that shoe, and I've had numerous times to buy it. Like Foot Locker had it in my size, and so did East Bay for like months. And I'm like, eh, should I get it? Should I? And now it's gone. And that's the thing. Like, just buy it. Like, that's just the motive. If I really want something, just buy it, because I'm not going to be able to get it later or resell it. But you're totally right, because I tried so hard to get those, to get the bands, and I was unsuccessful because I missed out on, like, being able to cop something else. But I already had the Black Toes, so that was another one that I know was kind of heated up. But I could have gotten the All-Stars, but I was way too trying super duper hard to get something that was really sought after on everyone in the fucking United States that had the sneakers at. So yeah,
I got the images, the image of the 10 silhouettes on the screen right now. So if the chat wants to chime in, which one is their favorite, which one is their least favorite, how they feel about quote unquote tampering with the Chicago ones, maybe they'll let us know in the chat. And like the one that I love the most, I didn't tell you which one's my favorite yet, but the Vapor Max is my favorite. It's such a new silhouette, and like for me, okay, there's no history behind it. You just go nuts with it just because it's so new and it has no heritage, no history. And that silhouette, that canvas, yeah, do whatever you want with it, man. Like it's an awesome shoe to begin with, and get us excited for the silhouette because there's a lot more to come. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I really do like the one. I want to get one shoe out of this collection. If I don't get the one, I will be super upset and super just want to cry. No, just kidding. But I really do want to try for the Vapor Max because everyone knows how much I love that shoe, and I really think it would be great to have in my collection. However, I did get something in my email from Nike inviting me. I signed up to go to New York to be able to get a chance to buy a pair, and it said I was confirmed. So if that's the case, your girl is going to have a hard choice between picking against the Vapor Max and the one.
I don't know exactly what that confirm thing is. So maybe in the chat or in the comments below, if you're watching this afterwards, let us know if you actually got on the sneakers app, if you got a confirmation or a reservation for one of these things. Because the message you got from the app seemed kind of vague.
So it wasn't even from the app. Hold on, let me pull up the email. So it actually was an email from Nike. I have it pulled up right here that just said New York made. And it says, it kind of goes into detail about New York and Nike, the attitude of the city, and different things like that. And they have 2 weeks that they're going to be releasing really new products. You know, Nike plays a big part in Soho, this and that, blah, blah, blah. And it kind of just shows, you know, the 10 icons with Virgil. And then it asks, you hit learn more about like the Virgil part of it, and it asks if you want to confirm a booking. And so I hit it and it said you're in. We'll let you know when we can reserve you a spot. Stay tuned for more info for a collaboration. So I think, and it asks me on here if I want to cancel the spot or not. So I think, I don't know. So we'll see.
I got Jonathan Crandall from the chat. He's saying that it says he's confirmed as well and waiting to let him know when he can reserve a spot. So it looks like I said before, it's like a reservation for a reservation to get a spot to, you know, take your pick of what's left at the pop-up, or not a pop-up, but the launch event or whatever they want to call it at Nike.
Yeah, I mean, I'm into it. It's dope. But let's move on to the next subject here. That way we can see anyone else that participates in the chat. So good news for you, Eugene. I did hear rumors of a re-release of the Clot.
I heard that too. And in fact, there is a re-release, because this, even though the designer is Canadian, he's actually based out of Hong Kong right now. So the international release of this thing had happened the same time Europe has. Overseas, they're gonna get another chance of the shoe. So I think it's gonna be the the official website of Clot. That's one of the options you can try your luck at. But those kind of websites and that kind of hysteria around a high profile shoe, like, your odds are pretty shitty, but it's still a chance, right?
Yeah. Keep your fingers crossed. So another shoe that I'm super duper excited about, this is kind of making me too hesitant about the pink trainers, is Nike is doing a collab with Skepta. So they're going to be doing the Air Max 97, and that's going to be available on the sneakers app in the US. I don't know if you guys have a date in Canada for that, Eugene. But this comes out September 2nd, and this is definitely a cop for me if I can get it.
We talked about this, over messages a little bit, and I am feeling this. It's that iridescent outer that they've been playing with, especially in a lot of skate shoes, and it's a very interesting look. The 97, of course, a huge year for them this year because the 20th anniversary of the Air Max 97. Absolutely loving what they're doing with this silhouette right now. But the one I'm actually looking forward to the most is the undefeated ones that you showed me last week.
Yes, the undefeated ones are super dope. And I also sent you a picture of it. There is another 97 that I'm really feeling as well. I'm not too sure when the release date for that is, but it's kind of like a crazy color look to it. It's it's called a vibrant new colorway. That's what the title said. I saw that online, and it has like hints of like peach, white, pinks, and then like yellow bright laces. That to me is super duper dope. I'm really loving the 97s right now. I love the look of the shoe. I, however, am not a fan of the new silver ones that came out though. I like the OG ones better. I just don't really like that like fakey look to the silver part of it. Not really into that, but I do like that kind of like shininess on these Skeptics here. So that's definitely something that I'm keeping my eye out, and the undefeateds are super dope too. I love black shoes. So cool. So let's get into the next topic. If you're in the chat, please participate in this because I would love to hear your outtakes on it. So I kind of just want to talk about like famous people all of a sudden being sneakerheads. So sometimes I watch those Complex videos where they kind of go sneaker shopping with the celebrities. Some of them are actually super duper cool. Some of them are super duper whack. So one of the ones that I really liked was one that they did with Logic, because he actually like talked about like how he like, you know, grew up with Dunks. He grew up with these Jordans, different things like that. And to me, like, all right, cool, man. Like, you are a sneakerhead. Like, you know your shit. But then again, we get these people that just like fucking wear sneakers and like act like they're sneakerheads when really like what, like you just buy this shit because you just buy it to, like, you know, just to be a part of the generation today. What are your thoughts on this, Eugene?
Of course there are actual legitimate sneakerheads that just also happen to be famous, and yeah, that's not who you're talking about, but we're talking about people that get a lot of, you know, screen time, a lot of press attention, and I don't know exactly whether or not that's a good influence for the general consumers of certain brands, and it's hard for me to say, because like I might not like a certain brand, or I might not like a certain lifestyle, but if I had the money and I could afford it, like, we're talking about like fuck you money kind of afford things, and I would definitely maybe dabble in that lifestyle. And if sneaker and fashion is part of it, I think that's, you know, an area I'd like to explore as well. And I have a feeling a lot of these celebrities or high profile people that have money, maybe that's their thing. It's just an image for them, as not so much a lifestyle.
Yeah, it kind of just like makes me think, like, and not only that, but like I kind of want to talk about too, like, does like celebrity collaborations make a shoe more desirable for you? Like, for example, like Travis Scott with the VaporMax, Tyler the Creator the One Stars, and yes, Tyler the Creator with the One Stars does make it so desirable for me. Joe was making fun of me when we were in New York. He's like, just buy these One Stars right here. I'm like, no, they're not the Tyler the Creator ones. Like, I want his. And a big reason is that I want his is because I love his new album, and I really love him as an artist. Like, I've been listening to him for years, and I just feel like when he, you know, goes in on his tracks, like, he has so much heart, like, when he's in there. And, like, that's why I love it. But then we get people that just buy stuff because this person wore it or that person wore it. Like, people that fucking were on Supreme today that bought that Nas tee, I bet they never listen to Nas a day in their life, and they're fucking wearing a t-shirt that says Nas on it.
Oh, I it depends, man. Like, what if there are a newer generation that listens to modern day or new age hip hop and whatnot, and they don't understand the importance of Nas in the hip hop history or his relevancy in all of the culture, and they just happen to know who he is, and you know, it's a nice shirt and this and that, but you know, like, are these people that are buying, like, you know, band t-shirts or, you know, the Supreme the screen printed shirts, that they don't own a single album of those artists in their entire collection? Are they posers now? Are they hype beasts? Like, what do you consider them to be?
So I think it is kind of like a hype beast thing to wear the band t-shirts. I mean, I'll be honest with you, I have like a couple band t-shirts, but I have listened to them before. Do I listen to them on the reg? No, but I like the look of it. I like the concept of it. I think it's cool. It looks like vintagey. So I can't really knock on that. But for people that kind of like just try to be someone that they're not and kind of like go into this like scene where they're wearing, you know, the Supreme hype shirt. Like, yeah, I may have like a band t-shirt that I got from like fucking Forever 21 that just like looks super dope and it was super cheap. Am I spending so much amounts of money to be like someone that I'm not? Fuck no. Like, if you don't like me for me, like, that's totally cool. Like, that's your loss. Just kidding. But I just think it's kind of just, like, crazy because it is kind of true. Like, for me, like, I gave you that example. I really want those One Stars by Tyler, the Creator, because him being the one that wore it, like, that influences me to want them and buy them more. I could easily buy the ones that are sitting on the shelves that are just plain One Stars without Tyler, the Creator's logo on it for $85. But his are like reselling for like $200 to $300. It's crazy for a Converse.
It really depends on what you're trying to accomplish. And for me, I only like buy certain looking clothes just because I'm into that lifestyle. But like, you know, me and you, we kind of fuck with Supreme as much as we can possibly get our hands on. But like, can you call ourselves legitimate like skaters? And like, what does that make us? Does that make us just like these people that are wearing the band or Nas t-shirts when they don't own a single album? I own a couple of skate decks, but they're hanging on my wall with no trucks and no wheels, right? Like, what does that make me? Like, I'm just as much of a poser and a hype beast as some of these people because I like the design of something aesthetically as opposed to the actual relevancy of what that image represents.
And I totally agree with you on that because, you know, I am the same way. But there comes like a line of things where, you know, it's more of like that's just like your look. That's what you like. But it's, are you doing that because you like it or are you doing that because you want to fit in? Like, are you doing that to like gain attention, to like get people to like you or like, you know what I mean? So I get like, I see a lot of that sometimes where people change the way that they are to kind of fit more in with that lifestyle that's going on today.
I definitely am one of those people, but I keep it as low key as possible. But it's hard,
Mr. Vape up here.
Well, that's the thing, man. Like, I like certain aesthetics, and just because I like the way a skateboarder dresses or the clothing available to them doesn't mean I have to go out and learn how to skateboard to, you know, appreciate that fashion sense, right? Like, there's all these people wearing like bomber jackets that don't fly airplanes, like, you know, like, that's just the way it is.
That's funny. That's so true. But yeah, I think it's really cool though that a lot of celebrities kind of are influencing the sneaker world. Don't get me wrong, I think it's dope. The only reason why I brought it up is because I think sometimes it gets portrayed in a different way. But yeah, that's kind of my thoughts on it. So if anyone is listening and they have anything they want to ask or anything that they want to share, like, we're open ears.
Yeah, so I just want to address the chat. First of all, thank you for everyone that watched another one of these live streams. It's kind of hectic trying to get these things together, and a lot of these elements are put in last minute. That's why we're a couple minutes late trying to set everything up, and I appreciate your patience and you guys supporting us and doing what we're trying to do. We're trying to give you, you know, like I said on the podcast as well, it's like it's not really, we're not giving out facts and this and that. We throw out the facts and give you our opinions on it, and everything's up for discussion, and that's why there's a live chat going on. And of course, if you have any questions for us or anything that you absolutely disagree with what we've said, let us know in the chat. Like, nobody's wrong unless you're absolutely wrong, but like at the same time, let us know exactly what you think of all the topics that we've covered. And if you want any if you have any feedback for us, let us know, and we can slowly implement some of your suggestions to make the show more cater to you guys.
You guys ever want to reach me or chat, like, hit me up on my Instagram or hit me up on Twitter. It's BrookieDoo, BrookieDoo. And I also have a website, so that's BrookieDoo.com. So, yeah, I mean, we're always here to talk. Like, I actually met Eugene as just a listener and just someone that, like, slid him a message, like, talking about shoes. And here we are, like, best buds across the world.
I don't know, man. If we were really best buds, I would have like a size large Supreme shirt in a couple of weeks. So
I fucking tried for you. No, I actually might. I'll keep you posted. One of my homies buys a lot of larges, and I'm gonna see if he bought an extra. I'll text him tonight and let you know.
All right. It is what it is. I know it's impossible to try and secure some of these things, and I understand how it is.
We have anyone posting up in the chat?
Let's just get into a few of the comments that while we were talking about the celebrities and whether or not they actually are legitimate sneakerheads. Let's see. We got Ovechkin YT. If they get the shit for free, then they ain't really sneakerheads. Like, what do you think about that?
I mean, I can somewhat agree to that, because it's like they don't really appreciate the hunt for the shoe. It's kind of like something that they just open. But at the same time, if they get it free, there's probably, you know, prizes in it for them. Or if they wear it, they maybe get something else for ruining the brand. But no, I kind of do agree with that. It's kind of hard to agree and disagree. It's kind of like what we just talked about. Like, we both like Supreme, but do we skateboard? No. So if someone's throwing something in your face, are you going to wear it? Are you going to take it? Like, you know, what do you think, Eugene?
Here's the thing of, you know, getting free sneakers. It looks like, OG Sneakers was making a point that Mark Wahlberg gets a lot of free sneakers from Nike, and you can't legitimately say that he's not a sneakerhead, because like, he's deep into this culture. And I think how these brands, kind of find people to give free shit to is like, look at Marky Mark, he loves sneakers. How about we send him some free sneakers, because he already established that kind of lifestyle, and it's something that he can relate to. And it that's how you start building a rapport with brands and high profile celebrities, is that, you know, you give something here, and then Marky Mark will show him on Instagram, like, fucking showing off the shoes, and now both brands gets exposure, and everybody's happy. And there's a lot of really low-key celebrities that are, like, sneakerheads. Like, do you know who Jason Sudeikis is?
No, what is he in?
He's a SNL alumni, and he's, like, a comedian. He's married to, like, Olivia Wilde, so he's doing okay, and he doesn't really go out there and say, I love sneakers and this and that, but like, every time he gets like paparazzi'd, he's always wearing like crazy heat. We're talking about like shattered backboards and Royals and like shit that like mere mortals like us can't really touch. And like, he never talks about how he's a sneakerhead, but every single time, like, you know, a reporter gets him on the camera or whatever, like, he's always wearing heat.
Yeah, and another one to call out, I don't know if anyone here watches this show, one of my fucking favorite shows, and I was so sad when I finished season two, Anees Asaro. You ever watch his show?
The one on Netflix. I know who he is, and I watch his I'm blowing out smoke while I talk. And I watch his comedy specials, so I know very well who he is, and I know, like, he's friends with Kanye. That's what everyone knows him for.
So, well, the irony, he in the season wears a fucking pair of shoes that I really want, the Nike Kill Shots. Like, they're a fucking classic, like, sick, like, little, like, Nike shoe, and he fucking has them. Like, those shoes are crazy rare to get. Like, you can't really find them anywhere.
And, like, those are the kind of celebrities I think that are very good for brand and imaging. It's, like, just low-key sneakerheads and hype beasts that don't really have to flaunt it. They don't have to be like, look at all the expensive shit I'm wearing. Look at all the rare shit I'm wearing. Like, those are, what do you call it? Those are accidental trendsetters, so to speak, you know? Like, no one's paying attention to the shoes that they're wearing, but it just happens to be the topic of every hypebeast blog post.
Oh yeah, for sure. Like, a big part of the reason why I brought up the Complex video is, I'll give you an example. The one that I watched with Logic was so cool. The reason why I liked that was because he kind of, like, went into the history of, like, why he liked each shoe. Talked about, like, the dunks. He had on a pair of dunks that I really do like. They're like the chicken and waffles. Have you ever seen them? SB Dunks, chicken and waffles.
I know what they are. They came out just, what, a year or two ago? So I have an idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, they're a pretty dope shoe. And he was just kind of talking about, like, the Jordans that he was into. And then I saw one with little Yachty, and I was just like, oh, my God.
Yeah, when you watch those shopping...
I feel like I lost brain cells watching that video.
And that's a great example, because when you watch those sneaker shopping videos on Complex, you can tell right away, like, what kind of sneakerhead they are. Like, some people are like, oh, I remember when I was a kid and I had this shoe, now I need to get it again. Oh, this is the first time I ever got a Jordan. And it's very easy to tell, like, who's a real sneakerhead. Like, they know the back... like.
Yeah.
I don't understand why people are just discounting celebrities just because they can afford these shoes, and, like, just because they don't have to hunt for them anymore doesn't mean that they can't legitimately be passionate about that culture. I think that's just, like, a misconception on the celebrity world of, you know, if you can get it, then you don't want it anymore just because it's so easy for you. And as much as I appreciate the hunt for sneakers, if people were handing me shit, I'd be just as appreciative of that.
Yeah, you can send it my way any day.
And I don't know, like, is there any low-key or celebrities that seem like they're sneakerheads that you follow or that we'd be surprised to know?
Personally, like, I feel like a lot of the celebrities that kind of, like I love Travis Scott, and he's into the Vapor Maxes. Like, I love Kanye West. He obviously is Adidas. I do get down to Justin Bieber, so I can dig that. But I mean, it's kind of like, a lot of times when I feel like you see, like, rappers, like Drake is a great example. Like, I feel like when Drake wears sneakers, like, his, like, whole, like, persona and just his look and his style just, like, reminds me of, like, I don't know, like, playing basketball on the playground. I don't know why it does, but, like, he'll always be rocking, like, a Jordan 1 or, like, some type of Nike shoe or just something that's just, like, such heat. But, like, the way that he wears it is just, like, he, like, is, I feel like he's very genuine to, like, the Nike brand, and I really value that.
There's, like I said, there's a bunch of, like, the ones that are most interesting to me are the really, really low-key sneakerheads that just happen to be a celebrity or a singer or an actor or whatever. There's a British pop singer. Her name's Lily Allen. Do you know who that is?
Mm-mm. I'll look her up.
Lily Allen's a British pop singer. And I think she's the sister of Alfie Allen from Game of Thrones. And she's, like, she gets handouts from Nike, and, like, she also is, like, a member of, like, the Nike lab, and she's always wearing everything. Like, she got, like, Air Maxes like crazy, and she got, like, the Cause 4s and all that stuff. But if she... Exactly, like, she's one of those low-key celebrities that just happens to be a sneakerhead at the same time, and that's the shit that's the most exciting to me, like, finding out who the real sneakerheads in the celebrity world.
You know who's another one? You ever watch the show Entourage?
I know of it, and I tried to watch it, but it just killed too many brain cells.
Oh my god, stop it. That show's so great. This cool a character on there named Turtle. Fucking, you want to talk about low-key sneakerhead? This
he's not low-key anymore. They made like an entire shoe for him, and he had episodes dedicated to his sneaker passion. Like he's a Dunks guy, right?
He wore a lot of Jordans, actually, and from what I remember in Entourage.
And I know exactly the character you're talking about, and like for someone that doesn't even watch the show, and I already know of that plot line and that character development when it comes to his sneaker obsession. Yeah, I guess it's low key, but at the same time, it's well known as well.
So I just looked up like celebrity sneakerheads just to see, like anything to pick a bell, and one of them that like kind of makes me laugh and like legit is like really cool, Jerry Seinfeld.
I remember Hypebeast or Complex did an entire article on the sneaker history of the Seinfeld TV show.
That's crazy. I'll have to check that out.
He wore a lot of like trainers, like he wore a lot of like the Andre Agassi shit, like all the really hip dad shoes back in the 80s. And I think
dad shoes are out now, catching waves.
Oh man, I gotta show you something later that it's gonna be a surprise. But there's something in the works on dad shoe fashion when it comes to what we're trying to do on the podcast. But yeah, look out for that. But what other like celebrity sneakerheads can you see?
So we got Teyana Taylor. Have you ever heard of her? I never heard of her before. We have Just Blaze. Never heard of that person. Ludacris. Ludacris, that's a good one. Because I feel like his old like music videos, you'd see him in there. Rock.
That and I remember during a run of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, there was a lot of interesting sneakers there as well.
And I just see your boy Jason, too. He popped up.
Yeah, man. He's huge into sneakers. And like I said, every time they get a shot of him, it's always in some fire shoes. So, I don't know, like, is there anything you want to finish your thought on the celebrity scene? How legit is it? Is it worth our attention? Or do you think it's something that's just inevitable? Like, we have to live with celebrities wearing shit, and then kids will want it because they've seen the celebrities wearing it. What do you think of the whole movement, just to wrap this up?
So, to wrap it up, I think it's kind of like we touched on it pretty much just to clear it up. We see people that we like. We see people that we want to be. Maybe it's an inspiration to style. So I feel like seeing them with a shoe definitely gives you more of a desire to want it, especially if you have a passion for that celebrity. Like, you really genuinely follow them. You like their music. You like them as an actor, an actress. So that's my thing.
I think it can be positive and negative. Like, a shoe that absolutely doesn't warrant any attention, next thing you know, it sells out just because certain people wear it. Like, a good example are those Flyknit trainers, and they shouldn't be sitting on the shelves for months and months. Next thing you know, a couple of photos pop up with certain celebrities wearing it, and those Flyknit trainers are sold out, and they resell for $400 or $500.
So. See, it definitely has its highs and lows, but it's kind of, that's the sneaker market for you. Like, that's just never going to change. So if you really want it and they wore it, like, you're going to pay because it makes it even more desirable for you.
Yeah, that's exactly it. Like, maybe, hopefully, a lot of these younger collectors, the millennials out there, won't be so influenced and persuaded by an image of someone they look up to, but have maybe more of their own unique taste. And if someone says a shoe is trash and you actually like it, maybe don't fall right into that trap right away and be like, I don't want it anymore because so-and-so said it's trash.
Yeah. No, I agree with you on that.
So,
you want to wrap it up then?
Yeah, I'm just going to throw out a few information here and there out there. So, yeah, you can find us online at sneakerfiles.com. You can find us on Twitter at, hold on, I'm going to just pop this up. And you can find us on Twitter at SneakerFiles. And you can find us on Instagram at SneakerFiles_podcast. And it was another experimental little episode that we bring out to you. It's going to get a little bit more smooth as we get things locked down and more regular. And thank you again to everyone that's been watching and is watching after this live stream. Hopefully it'll be a lot smoother for the next few episodes. And I really appreciate everyone coming out to support this little experiment of ours. And basically, it means a lot to Brooke and I that we get a chance to interact with any of our followers or viewers or listeners. And there's a lot coming out on the Sneaker Files side. Make sure you tune in every Sunday for the Sneaker Files podcast. You can download those on like iTunes and on Google Play. You can stream it on sneakerfiles.com, and you can even catch the YouTube video of that actual recording that we do at Stay Fresh. And you can find this show, Sneaker Files Live with Brooke, every Thursday at 8:30 p.m. and if everything goes according to plan, it should be on time. And I'll let you sign off there, Brooke.
Cool. Thanks again, guys. Eugene, you couldn't have said it better. Really appreciate you guys watching, participating. We want to keep this going. So next week, hopefully it will be a lot more smoother. So just hang in there. It's going to get better, guys. And also, too, I'm going to have some things in the works. I actually just got a logo made, so I'm going to have some T-shirts. So I'm only going to do a few first, but I got to, you know, hook my brothers up at the Sneaker Files with it. So, yes. But besides that, you can find me on Instagram at Brookie Doo, BrookieDoo, 3 O's, and as well on Twitter, and then on my website, www.brookiedoo, just 2 O's, .com. I'm going to connect on both, so it's not going to be so confusing. But thank you so much, guys, for watching, and I hope to see you next week. It was great. Brookie Doo out.